Serious, when driving at night, what is the scariest, most unexplainable thing you've ever seen? Attention, serious, tag notice. Jokes, puns, and off-topic comments are not permitted in any comment, parent or child. Parent comments that aren't from the target group will be removed, along with their child replies. Report comments that violate these rules. Posts that have few relevant answers within the first hour, and posts that are not appropriate for the serious tag will be removed. Consider doing an AMA request instead. Thanks for your cooperation and enjoy the discussion. I am a bot, and this action was performed automatically. Please contact the moderators of the subreddit. Message composed to equals r ask reddit if you have any questions or concerns. Scariest only because it nearly killed me. Driving back from a late high school football game that I was covering, I was going through a very remote section of highway and farmland. I was a little zoned out, but the road was straight and wide for a while. I was going along at a good clip when I was vaguely aware that there was suddenly something in my way, but it was almost just a sense of it, not anything I could really see. Something just didn't look right, and I could tell hitting the brakes was not going to help. So I swerved into the opposing lane and passed something large that had been blocking my lane. I still didn't know what it was, but it was large. I got turned around and went back slowly to see what the heck I had barely missed. When I got close enough to see better in my headlights, there they were. Two very large, completely black cows. They were big enough that my hatchback would have been totally crushed if I'd hit them, and it could have easily been a fatal accident for me and the cows. I called the local police and they sent a car out while I waited to make sure no one else hit them, even though the cows wandered off the road a ways and I hadn't seen another car for quite a while. When they got there, they knew who the cows belonged to and called the guy up all pee off because this apparently happened more frequently than they liked. TLDR. Dang, cows nearly killed me. About 20 years ago, I was driving home from a late wedding DJ gig. I was driving south on a major interstate which was relatively empty at 2:30 a.m. or so. At one point, in the narrows, the retaining walls on each side get very high as the highway snakes underneath overpasses. Out of nowhere, a young woman jumped down from the retaining wall onto the highway and directly in front of my car. I hit the brakes hard, came to a complete stop, and nearly slammed into her. She looked up, ran to my passenger door and got in looking terrified. She looked between 16 and 20 years old, long blonde hair, and her clothes looked a little dirty. Not homeless dirty, but like she'd fallen down a few times. "I just need to call my mom," she said. I tried to calm her down and began moving back down the highway, and behind me about 50 feet, I see another figure jump down onto the highway out of my rear view window. I didn't mention this to her and she didn't look back or see the other person. I sped up and went about 4 or 5 exits south. She kept saying over and over, "I just need to call my mom." This was before most people had cell phones. So I told her I would take her to one of the 24-hour grocery stores and she could call her mom. I asked her if she needed money for a payphone, what was wrong, etc. She said nothing other than, "I just need to call my mom." I pulled up to the grocery store and stopped. She got out quickly, but not running, then ducked into the grocery. She didn't say a word to me or look back. I pulled into the gas station across the street and called 911 and told them the entire story and let them know the young woman was inside the grocery store and a description of her. I have no idea what happened. I don't know why she did that, what happened to her, who the figure behind us on the highway was. Nothing really made me super uneasy. I think I did the right thing. I would have tried to do more, but she seemed really fragile emotionally and somewhat afraid of me. I am a guy, so I wanted her to just be able to get to where she needed to be. Hey man, you definitely did the right thing. I hate to think of what might have happened to her if you hadn't helped Jay. Was driving with some friends at around 2 a.m. Rainy cold night, along a winding section of road with a steep drop off to the river below on one side. We pass a small pull off and notice a car with no lights on. As we drive by, we catch a glimpse of a person standing next to it, and as the headlights hit him we see his shirt is covered in blood all down the front. We don't stop, but turn around and drive back slowly. I roll down my window as we approach, and he just stands there, blood all over his shirt and pants. His car looks fine, couldn't have been a crash. Out the window I ask if he's okay, and over the pounding rain and roar of the river below I hear the most distant and sorrow I'm fine. Gave me chills. I don't reply and slowly drive off as my buddy calls the cops. About half an hour later we drive by again and there is an ambulance and a couple cruisers. Turns out the guy slit his wrists and was going to jump off into the river. Cold, rainy and pitch black. Scary where your mind can take you. There's a public park near my house, which gets pretty dark at night. I was driving home tired and exhausted after midnight when I realized that someone had dragged all the garbage cans and other large items out into the middle of the road to form a barricade of sorts. I'm not sure if it was just a lame prank or if someone was waiting for a car to stop so that they could rob the person. I didn't bother to find out. There was just enough room for my small car to slip through. It's happened twice in the past few weeks, so I'm going to assume it's just some teenagers being jerks. Call the police. Since it happened a couple times, then something is up. A big cougar running next to my car then for no reason decided to commit suicide and run under the side. I wasn't sure if it fricked my car up and was terrified to get out and check. Eventually my 18-year-old brain decided I should check. It was dead, but looking back that was really dumb of me. This story is one where I was the one that, unintentionally, scared somebody. I was driving home from a friend's late one evening, probably around 3 a.m. The town I live in and grew up in has a reputation for being a racist area thanks to a few high-profile incidents and a reasonable amount of racist idiots having lived here in the past. As I approached the town, I was going round a roundabout when a car joins, ignoring my right of way and cuts me off a bit. It was a crap bit of driving, but I'm reasonably good at not letting that get to me. What was mildly irritating though was given how keen the driver was to get out onto the roundabout in front of me. He then drove about 5 miles per hour below the speed limit on the way into the town, and like I said, it's late and I just want to get to bed. About a mile later we reach the main street of the town, which has many turnoffs, and I'm still sat behind them. They pick one of the quieter turnoffs, which is the one I usually use to get home. At the end of that street they can go left or right and still end up at the other end of the housing estate. They choose right, which is where I need to go. Then they have a few turnoffs in both directions before hitting another main road. They choose the quietest turnoff, I presume thinking I'm following them and wanting to see if I actually am or if I'm just making my way into the main road. Unfortunately for them, they've turned onto my road. They're crawling along it at this point, obviously slightly worried. The driver probably thinks I'm still pee about being cut off and I'm following him for some sort of revenge. So they decide to pull in and let me pass. They indicate and pull across a driveway which just happened to be mine. I had to pull alongside them and open my passenger side window. The driver opens his and there's 2-3 black teenagers in the car, all looking slightly terrified by the pretty big skinhead. Not by choice. White guy who has been following them and now pulled up alongside them in the middle of a quiet estate in an area known for being racist. The look of relief on his face when I said, "Sorry mate, that's my driveway you blocking," there was pretty hilarious. Poor kid was scared shitless, but somehow in trying to get rid of me made a series of road choices that convinced him he was about to be murdered. Car in front of you before they turn. Please don't go right. Please don't go right. You. Please don't go right. This woman was on the side of the road and asked me to come look at her car, which was parked in a large turnoff. I asked what was wrong and she just kept saying to come look. I apologized and drove away and she just stood there while I drove away. More weird than scary, but it was night in the country and I was alone. While working one night was called to attend a head-on car accident with 3 people killed. The driver of one vehicle wasn't wearing a seatbelt and the force of the impact had embedded his steering wheel in his forehead. His best mate was in the seat next to him and was conscious and making the most horrific shrieks. We'll never forget that image or that sound. I was driving to work at 3 in the morning. I work at an airport, and I was in the middle lane doing 70 miles per hour when a lady ran at my car, in the middle of a highway, waving her arms. I swerved into the left lane so fast I couldn't believe I didn't hit her later, and kept going. I would have stopped, I really would have, but something in her face didn't say I need help. It was more I'm on massive amounts of drugs. When I got to my lot 10 minutes later I called 911 and told them what happened. I never heard anything or saw anything in the papers, so I assume she wandered away. I used to work by LAX in a small office park just south. As I was leaving, driving past the Air Force base just down the way, some guy in a suit, like typical business attire, ran through the center of the street in pitch black darkness. I can sorta relate. I thought I was driving into Silent Hill when the road looked like it was flaking off and blowing away. Just Nebraska after harvest and the dried husks were blowing away. I was driving in Maine and there was a moose just hanging out on the highway. I just remember screaming and driving in the breakdown lane. I never realized how big a moose was. I also don't know why it was calmly standing there. I had something creepy happen to me a few months ago. I was driving home after seeing a play with a friend of mine, so it was probably around 11:30 PM 12:00 AM. Also, I live in rural America, so there weren't any street lamps or houses for the majority of the drive. I was driving over this bridge and saw a car sitting on the side of the road turned on. I wasn't really concerned about it because it's a common spot for cars to pull off, even if it was kind of late. As I passed the car, I looked in my rearview mirror and saw that they had pulled out behind me. Again, I didn't really think anything of it, until they began to tailgate me hard. While that behavior isn't unheard of, it tends to be rare since the road is curvy and a hotspot for deer. I kept driving for a bit with this car right up on me, which caused me to feel frustrated, confused, and strangely paranoid. Then, the car's headlights went out abruptly while I was nearing the end of a stretch of road surrounded completely by forest. This made me freak the frick out because it was still super close behind me. Then, the car sped up and went around me, but almost immediately slowed down to a standstill in front of me. At this point I was so afraid, so I sped up, went around the car, and drove way too fast to get home and then sprinted inside and locked the door. I didn't notice the car around my house, but I still feel worrisome about the entire ordeal and wish I knew why someone would drive like that. When I was a kid, living in Charleston, SE, my dad took me and my brother to a boat landing on a creek, right off of the intercoastal waterway to shoot off some fireworks we had left over from the 4th. This boat landing was up in the sticks in a place called Watmalaw Island, very sparsely populated and pitch black at night. When we pulled in the parking lot of the boat landing, around 11 PM, there was a 20-ish foot powerboat nestled against the dock. The only people there were several guys wearing white boots and loading the back of an SUV with boxes from the boat. There was also a sports car, not sure what kind. We instantly got the heebie-jeebies, turned around and hauled butt. About 30 seconds later, there was a car speeding towards us in the rearview mirror. We were already going 80 miles per hour, because my dad was convinced it was drug-related, and it was gaining very quickly on us. We knew we couldn't outrun them. My dad drove an 81 Audi Fox, so before we went around a curve in the road, we killed the headlights and pulled into the driveway of someone's house, ducked down and waited. That car that was chasing us flew by, must have been going 100 miles per hour, easily. We sat there for a few minutes and saw the car going back to the boat landing. Crap could have ended very differently. I'm guessing sea shipment? TLDR. Me. My dad and my brother witnessed a drug delivery, got chased and barely escaped. Nice move on your dad's part. I've been waiting wanting to post this for so long, and now I'm late to the party. Anyway, I was driving very late at night through a pretty big park in NYC but not Central Park. Now this was after an all-night film shoot for one of my friends in college and I had been up for a very long time. As we were driving past the rec building with the pool, I see a person galloping on all fours like a crab. They were moving so fast and I thought I had just been imagining it. But when I got home, my boyfriend at the time, who was sitting in the front seat, asked me if I saw the crab person. It was super spooky and I just can't explain it. My friend and I used to go drive around our little country town at all times of the day. We'd chat, listen to music, and just sort of drive around for no real reason. One night, we decided we were bored and that we should just take a drive around the back country roads and just chill out. The roads were just two-way, one lane each, with a speed limit of 45-55, I think. So, we pull out from my parents' house and start cruising down a normal road that we take. We pull up to the normal four-way stop and then keep heading out toward the country where the road gets a little bit more rough. On top of this, because it's actually out in the country. There isn't really any light aside from either the moon or the few houses that you pass on the way out. So, on the way out, I start getting this really weird feeling. I've driven this road tons of times before at night and I've never had this feeling before. It felt like a stone in my stomach along with some chills that were going up my legs and my arms. Around the time that I started feeling this, there was a car coming toward us going the opposite direction. We were maybe a mile or so away from one another, probably a bit more than that. My friend and I were still just talking and not really paying much attention to the car coming toward us. As it got closer, I remember feeling particularly uncomfortable and the conversation between my friend and I just sort of stopped abruptly. The car that was coming toward us was basically right in front of us at this point and it was about 2-3 yards in front of my car before it flipped its headlights off and veered into our lane, aimed directly at my car. This was all split second. Backcountry road, pitch black, and headlights coming toward us just cut off completely. I, by some miracle, managed to swerve to the right, not too violently, to get out of the way. My friend and I were shaken as frick. I checked my mirrors and just saw the car flip its headlights back on and continue driving from the way we came. I think my friend and I had 5-6 cigarettes between us on the drive home and we decided to cut the drive extremely short because of this weird crap. I still have no valid explanation other than maybe it was some drunk dude in a car just fricking around with us. Even writing this, I still get heavy chills lol. It was pretty wild. We were driving down the mountain from a campsite on an old, dirt road, headed for town. It was 4th of July weekend, so we had gone camping, and headed home just as it was getting dark. We go around a bend in the road and our headlights pick up on something huge hunkered down in the bushes on the side of the road about 30 feet in front of us. We slow down and we're trying to figure out what the F it is, because it's moving. We let the truck crawl until we're about 10 feet away. That's when our headlights pick up one very large eye. Dang bull moose stands up from the bushes and tears across the road in front of us, making that weird, grunting noise they use when they're grumpy. Let's shine a bright light on this giant creature in that bush, WCGW. Sounds like a bull moose was one of the better outcomes of that scenario lol. We were on a cross-country camping trip in the summer and we had been camping every night for 2+ weeks in different campgrounds every night. We were using a AAA guidebook to find the best campgrounds and they were almost always full of people. We read about one that was very well rated and free. When we got there it was late at night and we drove through looking for a good campsite. Problem was, we didn't see a single other person anywhere there. Dozens of spots, all empty. It was heavily forested and with it being so dark out and nobody else being there we all got a creepy vibe. I was only 12 or so but I was begging my parents to not stay there because I was so creeped out. My parents agreed and we went somewhere else. Never found out why it was empty or what the deal was but I've never been that creeped out before for seemingly no reason. I was driving to Growler Mountains once on a very foggy night. A herd of elk becoming visible through the fog ahead of you is pretty scary. In 1994, my mom and I were driving from Colorado to Montana for my uncle's wedding. I was 4 and sitting in my car seat in the passenger's seat. We were in a fairly nice white rental for the trip because our family car definitely couldn't make the drive. It was after midnight and dead quiet on this stretch of forest Y highway with no lights or houses. We were in between towns somewhere just before the Montana state line. My mom was going about 70 miles per hour on one of those thin, winding roads without a care in the world when bam, a gigantic buck was standing in the middle of the road. She swerved but the huge antlered bee jumped the same way, causing us to plow into it. Its body spun down the right side of the car, knocking off the mirror and denting the frick out of the door all while releasing a barbaric forest animal death cry that was unlike anything I've heard since. My mom was obviously shook and sped off because A, what if it's still alive? And B, we gotta find a phone and report it. Right? It took us about 20 minutes to get to the next town and find a bar. My mom ran in with me, both of us frantically crying, and all these burly men jumped up to help my mom. I assume they thought one of us was injured or in immediate danger. My mom relays the events through tears and then they all look at each other ask, well, did you keep it my 5-foot-tall 105 pounds? Mom tells them that no, She did not drag a buck with trophy size antlers into the car with her 4-year-old. They all started high-fixing and asked her for the closest mile marker to where she hit it because that's good meat. My mom used the bar phone to call the cops, and when she gave them the same story, they also asked if she kept it for meat. She figured country people in Montana are starving weirdos and that we should push through because we only had a few hours of driving left. We got to my uncle's house around 4 a.m. and immediately went to bed. Just after 7 a.m, someone starts banging on my uncle's front door like they have metal fists. It's the cops. They had gotten about 2 dozen calls in the half hour since the sun came up about a murder car in my uncle's driveway. It's our white rental, dotted in deer fur and absolutely caked in blood from the grill to the trunk, with the right side of the car looking like a crunched up tuna can. We had no idea we were driving around in a nightmare mobile. My mom is horrified and tells the cops about the deer, her call to the cops a couple hundred miles away, and how scary it was. The cops deadass looked at my mom and asked her if anyone had claimed the deer for meat. We've not been back to Montana since that trip. TLDR. My mom dang near totaled our rental by mowing down an absolute unit of a buck on a rural stretch of Montana highway, unknowingly caking the car in guts. And everyone we told wanted to know what mile marker it went down at for free fresh venison. Somewhere in some bar in Montana, they tell the weird tale of the city slicker that got lucky enough to get a few hundred pounds of free meat and just decided not to keep it for some crazy reason. Once when I was 19, I got off work early at about 3 a.m. I always took the back roads to avoid dealing with highways, and really it was almost a straight road directly south of my job to get home. There aren't any street lights, and once you go about 2 miles, it turns into dirt road with a few four-way stops. On this night it's foggy and visibility is crazy low, so I'm only doing about 30 miles an hour. As I come up to one of the four-way stops, there's a house tucked back from the corner with an old lamppost in the middle of the yard, basically halfway between the intersection and the house. I had been intentionally looking for this lamppost as it was a good indicator of how far I'd gone down the road, as the fog was very thick and I was a bit nervous about it. I stop at the intersection and look over at the lamppost and see a man or a man-like figure standing beside it. Just standing there, at 3 a.m. on a foggy night. Goosebumps from head to toe, and the hair on the back of my neck stood straight out, and I immediately felt unsafe. The figure never moved as I drove through the intersection, but the rest of the trip was dirt road with high rows of cornfield on both sides. I'm doing 30 miles per hour, terrified, heart racing, just knowing at any moment that figure is going to walk out from the cornfields into the road and I'm gonna be murdered. Nothing did happen and I made it home just fine. But to this day it still gives me chills thinking about that figure. And just to be clear, I'd driven by that house countless times in the past and again after that. It wasn't a scarecrow or anything of the sort. I bet some dude needed to clear his head and came off a lot creepier than he wanted to. A few years ago, I was driving alone at night through a shopping center and noticed things seemed sped up a bit. Like when you watch a video at 1.25 speed. Everybody was walking and moving too fast. I actually shook my head trying to shake it off. A few minutes later I was fine. I still don't have an explanation of what I experienced to this day. One night my wife and I were driving home from a 2 a.m. Walmart trip along a particularly empty stretch of highway. We come up over the top of a long hill, and as the car levels out we see two deer halfway across the road. The deer that was leading the other broke into a sprint. The deer behind them froze, and I pumped the brakes all at the same time. Somehow this was all timed perfectly such that our car threaded the needle gap between the two deer that formed from the time when the one in the back froze till we got to the deer, maybe 200 feet at 65 decelerating to 45 mph. Nobody was harmed, human or deer. The car wasn't even grazed. We call that moment the deericle. Deericle, just take my upvote. About 6 years ago, my family and I moved from the West Coast to the Midwest. Dad and I drove while my mom and younger siblings flew. Dad was driving the U-Haul and I was driving the van that we had at the time. We stopped for dinner around 8 and realized we had about 6 hours of driving left and decided to push on through. GPS took us a very weird way and had us exit on a rural route highway instead of staying on the interstate. So we are following this little windy road for what seems like forever. It's just past midnight when all of a sudden we are in this little town. Everything seems old and the houses feel like they are 10 feet from the road. There's not a single street light in this town, so the only light is from our cars. We get to the house and my dad doesn't say anything about the town, so I assume it was my mind playing tricks on me. A few days later I tell the story to my mom and she tells me dad told her the exact same story but thought since I didn't mention it that it must have been his mind playing tricks. I've tried to find this town again on many occasions and I have never had any luck. If you are new to the channel, you can subscribe. I publish new videos every day. Until then, check another video. Bye for now.